Hey there, sister stylist. This is Hannah Steelman here, and I am in the Canva studio. I'm going to show you how to use your partyOTG template. It is so simple. So after you have already clicked the link to using the template, you're going to go to your Canva studio and you're actually going to see the template design pop up for you. So I'm going to go ahead and use our brand template. And this is what it's going to look like on your screen. You're going to have this first page here, which just has some videos to keep you on pace, but this is just a stylist notation page. So before you publish your partyOTG as a mini website, you're going to come up here and hit this delete button so that it is gone all together. Okay, so first things first, we want to come over here and add an image. Now, all of the images here are simple drag and drop pictures. So real quickly, we can just pop over to our uploads and find a photo that we want to drag and drop in there. So I'm just going to grab this one, drop it in. If you need to crop it, there's the crop button, and it'll allow you to move that photo around until it's a position that you like it. I'm going to do it one more time. All right. So the next thing is we're going to come down here to phone number. These, by the way, are text boxes that you're going to personalize and really try to bring forth your personality. Express yourself in these boxes, who you are, what you stand for. This is a great time to reference your five brand pillars. Let the customer know that you are who she wants to do business with in the future. So we're going to come down here to the phone number box. Now what you're going to do is just go ahead and type in your phone number. And then we're going to pop up here to link, and this is a key part to make sure that your party guests can actually text you from the party. So you're going to retype your phone number up here in link and hit enter. And now you'll see a line popping up underneath the phone number. Actually didn't do that for me this time. I don't know why it's not there. All right, there we go. And now you see this line underneath the phone number. This indicates that that link has already been created. So you can just keep scrolling and just kind of fill in the blanks. Make sure that you're reading each spot. I see that I have an empty button here. So what I'm gonna do is pop over here to this text, and I'm gonna add text to this button so that it becomes a usable button. So let's see, let's do skip the party. Shop now. All right, I'm going to drag this over the button. Then we're going to make it white so that it stands out. If you've used a text that doesn't fit, you can adjust the spacing. So that's what I'm doing right now, just so that we can get the majority of the text on this button. I'm going to zoom in so that we can navigate this placement just a little bit better. Sometimes if things are jumping a lot when you are placing them, if you zoom in, you have a little bit more control over that. So now I'm going to pop up here and again hit the link button. Now this is where I want to take the shopper either directly to the shopping link of the party or to your website's shopping page. So I'm going to start with the shop page. You guys already know how to grab your party links. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy this and come right back over here to the party, paste that in there. And then again, you are going to see the link come to life here. We didn't see this underlined, so it's not linked. We're going to do it again. And now that is that button is linked to the party. So when the shopper is coming through this party and they click, that will actually take them right to your website. So we're going to scroll down. There is another button I want to point out to you. Much of this, like if you already have your own application video, you can click here and just hit the delete button. And now there's new content there, or you can lay your own video right over the top. Nail fees are the same in this slide. We can just come over here to our uploads and find our favorite nail fees and just drag and drop them. So if you were doing a pedi party, it'd be great to drop pedicures in. Now I'm going to keep scrolling down. These are some more areas where you're going to input your own text, but right here is a button I really wanted to draw attention to, because the account creation is so incredibly important in our business to make sure we're getting that follow-up business. So I'm going to go ahead and drop this down here. If you don't know about the account creation, you can find more on my channel that explains why that is so important. Claim your free party swag. All right, so let's go ahead and make this. We're gonna scrunch it together, do the same thing we did with the last button, and get this baby moved up here to the button, looking good. So I'm gonna change the spacing again too, and then center it on the button. Now to find this link, girls, you're going to come up here, you're gonna again hit the link button. Now we're gonna go retrieve it from your customer facing site, hit the login button in the upper right hand corner, then come down and click the button that says create an account. This is the link that you're going to place over here on this claim your party swag button. So it's that simple. Everything in this party is simple, drag and drop. You can click on to the next video to see actually how to turn this into an interactive party website.